Today in the news, we get some e-catalog leaks of the Ryzen 3000, two folds instead of one, and some predictions for 2019. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Let's get started with AMD. Over the last few days, a Russian price tracking website called eCatalog listed what looks like the next generation of Ryzen CPUs. Cross-checking this information with the leaks that we had previously, we can see that it's pretty much the same thing. We get 6-core Ryzen 3s, 8-core Ryzen 5s, 12-core Ryzen 7s, and 16-core Ryzen 9s. The clock speeds are also very much improved with the first 5GHz Ryzen CPU, the Ryzen 7 3700X. At first, I thought that this was just the price tracking website using the leaks we had before and pasting them onto their website, but the absence of G-series processors and the missing 3850X makes me think otherwise. Those CPUs are supposed to come later in 2019, so that's pretty interesting. Also found in the Tech Power Up forums was a screenshot of an ASUS X470 motherboard with a supported processors list that included three of the Ryzen 3000 series processor. The L2 cache on that screenshot is wrong, but that could just be a typo. Anyways, we'll know for sure in the following week. Personally, I'm really hyped up to upgrade from my 1700. If I can grab double the cores, I definitely will. Moving on, what's better than a phone with one fold on a display? That's right, a phone with two folds on the display. Evan Blass on Twitter shared a video of what looks like the next generation of foldables. His source says that the phone is made by Xiaomi, but of course there's no way to confirm. I don't think that the video itself is fake though. I mean, I'd ask Captain Disillusion to debunk it, but he's probably tired of debunking small stuff like that. The only thing I really don't like about the foldable phones that we're seeing so far is the display protection on these. It just looks awful and flimsy and like a fingerprint magnet. Anyways, 2019 is sure to be packed with foldable phones, so I wouldn't be surprised if one of them came in this form factor. Now, since this is the start of a fresh new year, we've got some analysts making predictions, and predict they did. If you want to see all the predictions, the link is in the description down below, but I'll just go over two of them that I thought were interesting. One, Overwatch will become free to play this year, and so will Blackout. While I personally would be a little bit salty about it, this would probably be a great move from Blizzard for two reasons. First, the Overwatch League. Making Overwatch free to play would infuse a large number of gamers, many of which would become viewers of the league. The second reason is just money. I mean, I don't think that Blizzard could ever touch the amount of money that Fortnite makes strictly in cosmetics, but it would definitely infuse some cash into the system, which then could maybe make for faster updates to the game. As for Blackout, this would probably happen right before the announcement or release of the next Call of Duty. The second prediction, Nintendo will launch a fully handheld Switch for $199. The expectation would be a device with the Joy-Cons built in and no docking features. Personally, I think that this might be unlikely given the amount of games that support the Joy-Cons accelerometers. Another prediction was the announcement of a Switch Pro. Since there is a flaw in the Tegra chip that allows for easy hacking of the console, it is possible that an updated Switch with a fix for that shows up. As for actual performance gains, I don't think we'll see a Switch 4K this year. Here is one of my predictions. Crackdown 3 will be delayed again. That's it. I mean, I've been waiting for that game since 2016, so what's an extra year? Alright guys, so if you have any predictions or you just want to give your take on the two that were made here, I would love to hear about it in the comment section down below. Don't forget to drop a like there too, and you can click right here to see the latest video, and right here to subscribe to the channel, it would be greatly appreciated. Tell me what your predictions for 2019 are down in the comments, I'd love to hear it, alright? Stay frosty guys, take care. Oof, that was a nice snap to start 2019.